Beer pong. The game of champions, of legends, and of lovers. This simple game brings joy to college youths and sad dads trying to prove they're cool all across the country. A sport that dates as far back as the invention of beer itself. Beer pong, or pong as it is often referred to by sports historians, is a game of the people. But it hasn't always been that way.
When many people talk about the sport, beer pong, they only want to talk about the origin story or Matt Johnson's fabled shot of 83. But many people actually forget how the game became what it is today.
I mean, sure, we have the Regretto movement back in the 60s that standardized table dimensions. You have J.P. Solo, inventor of the Solo Cup in 78.
The Gentleman's Agreement of 1865.
But many people forget the person who changed the game forever. The woman who changed the game forever.
Joyce Chambers.
Now Joyce, she was a bartender down at the Student Union where my fraternity brothers and I used to play each weekend. We'd have 10 cup on Wednesdays and Fridays and 21 on Thursdays and Saturdays.
You see, back then beer pong was a man's game. For a woman to even come near the table, she'd be laughed at, kicked out of the bar.
It wasn't anything personal. That's just the way things were. It was the 40s. The war was going on. We never thought a woman would be able to compete.
Joyce was a quiet woman, paid her way through school working three or so jobs at a time. Now, this job specifically, the bartender gig at the Student Union, put her in a position that no woman had ever been in before.
And apparently what she would do is, she would stand behind the bar and just watch for hours. She learned all of the rules. Balls back, heating up, fire, seventh cup jitterbug. She learned their form, their trash talk, everything.
And all the while she's thinking, I can do this better than them. I can beat the boys at beer pong.
So one day, Joyce starts asking if she can play.
And we all laughed. I mean, it was the 40s. The war was going on. That's just the way things were. But she keeps asking for months on end.
And over this period of time where Joyce was trying to start to play, one of the top players at Amherst, a man by the name of James Cotton, started to take a fancy to her.
He would ask her out every night, show up to the bar with flowers, chocolates, penicillin, anything he thought would impress her. And night after night, she turned him down without even blinking an eye.
Until one night, Joyce presents James with a wager.
She would let him take her out on the town for one night, if and only if he could beat her at beer pong.
And this was insanity. I mean, she was out of her mind. How could a person who had never even played the game beat one of the best players in the state of Massachusetts?
Was I good? Son, you could have had a 10-rack split across the four corners of the bar, and I could hit each one blindfolded with a raccoon tied around my ankles. It was the 40s. The war was going on. That's just the way things were.
And so they play. And she can't hit a single cup.
She was hitting everything, and she could barely hit a rim.
So it comes down to the last cup he needs to win. And he hits it.
And the entire room is in stitches. I mean, they thought she would lose, but this badly?
But as the other men start to shuffle her away from the table, she calls it out. Redemption.
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 Redemption. So I give her the ball back, and she hits one, then two, then three, then four.
She hits all 10 cups, and they go into overtime.
The game goes on for 3 hours, quintuple overtime, until finally, she gets them. Game over.
She beat the boys at beer pong, and everything changed. Women were allowed to play the game and show that they too could compete. First just in Massachusetts, but then all across the country, all across the world.
If it weren't for Joyce Chambers, I wouldn't be able to play the game I love.
She's an absolute sports legend.
The Susan B. Anthony of beer pong.
The Rosa Parks of drinking games.
Some people say I'm a hero, but I just wanted to play.
Did I ever get that date with her? Why, yes, I did. And we've been married for 62 years.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very...